25 cases have been recorded in Western New South Wales hub Dubbo and surrounding towns, sparking major concerns for the largely unvaccinated regional population. It's sent 9 Western LGAs into lockdown. New South Wales Health is particularly concerned for the vulnerable Aboriginal communities living in that part of the state. Dr. John Hall, President of the Rural Doctors Association, joins us now from Brisbane. Dr. Hall, how has this happened?
Yeah, look, we know that there's been people that have moved through the areas of Dubbo and into Walgett in the far west while they've been infectious, unfortunately. To us, it looks like there's been a failure in the testing protocol. Normally, when someone's tested, they have to self-isolate before they get the result back. It appears that this particular person was allowed to move around before that test was actually negative. So that's probably one of the root causes for the current outbreak. But I think on a broader scale, it's really about people moving through the state. And obviously that's a concern. We've been calling for people not to move outside of areas of concern from the beginning of the pandemic, concerned about the impact that this could have on rural communities.
And Doc, what level of risk does this pose to the health services in the area?
Oh, look, it's really serious. I mean, we see this as a serious threat to the health security for these communities. Remembering that these communities have got a hospital, they have doctors that work across general practice and the hospital, you've got teams of nurses, allied health, pathology workers all working hard in the hospital. But if that hospital gets contaminated, or if that hospital had to deal with more than one case of someone who was critically unwell with COVID, that'd be overwhelmed fairly quickly. And that means you then don't have an emergency department, you don't have somewhere where you can go if you have a heart attack or a car accident. We're talking about, whole communities not having access to emergency care and health services if these services were overwhelmed.
So that's, you said 2 COVID cases in a hospital can just overwhelm the hospital.
Absolutely. Most of these hospitals have probably got the capacity to deal with one person with a serious critical illness at a time. We have really highly skilled doctors and nurses that do a great job out there, but we're limited by workforce and there just isn't the number of staff to deal with multiple cases at once. So if we saw, large numbers popping up in these communities, if we saw this outbreak of Delta causing multiple cases, that's on top of their business as usual of the heart attacks and the car accidents that are happening all the time anyway, it could certainly overwhelm the service and then you leave communities without access to emergency care.
Dr. Hall, I hear concern around the fact that Western New South Wales is home to a large and diverse number of Aboriginal communities. So what is it that makes them more vulnerable?
Where the focus is there's over 30% Indigenous population in that community. They're more vulnerable because they, unfortunately, we know there's a health gap. They have a lower life expectancy. They have higher rates of chronic disease and particularly renal disease. That means these people are unfortunately more vulnerable. And we know that if they were to get COVID, they're more likely to become seriously unwell and need hospitalisation. And unfortunately, the death rate's going to be higher in those communities.
All right, Dr. John Hall, we will have to leave it there. Thanks for your time this evening.
Thanks for having me.
With so much content online, it's sometimes hard to keep up with it all. And let's face it, who has the time? The project YouTube has you covered with the stories that matter. Hit subscribe for a daily list of the news that you need to know.